Dear students, myself, Dr. Sridhar, Assistant Professor of Mathematics, Government First Grade College, Gokak. Today, I tell you about some concepts in Boolean algebra and also prove some important theorems. So let us start. So first, in Boolean algebra, first we see what is a lattice. So lattice means it is defined as a partial ordered set is said to be a lattice if every two elements in a set A have a unique least upper bound and a unique greatest lower bound. Okay, so that is, it is defined as a partial ordered set is said to be a lattice if every pair of two elements have a unique least upper bound and a unique greatest lower bound. Okay. So, for example, if you see the example of this figure, okay, now let us call these points as A, this is B, and this is D, this E, this is H, F, G, this is I, and this is J. So in this figure, now see here, a pair of elements, say E and H, they don't have unique least upper bound. So this is not a lattice. For example, take the pair of elements E and H. So for E and H, there exist many upper bounds, say J, I. These are the two upper bounds. Upper bounds are H, J, I and F. So here there exist two least upper bounds, say F and H. So therefore, it is not a lattice. Similarly, consider another figure, say this one. Okay, so this is called this point as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, this is called as a lattice of positive integers. So it is a lattice of positive integers. Okay. So now in this figure, if you consider a pair of elements, say 1 and 2, here the 1 and 2 has a unique least upper bound, that is 2. Similarly, a pair of elements 2 and 3, it has a unique least upper bound, that is 3. And similarly, 3 and 4, they have unique least upper bound, that is 4. So like that, every pair of elements in this lattice has a unique least upper bound and a unique greatest lower bound. So it is a lattice. So this is a lattice. Okay, so this is all about lattice. Next, we study the properties of lattice. Properties of lattice. Okay, so a lattice is denoted by L, comma less than or equal to symbol. Okay, L, comma less than or equal to. So now the properties are, let L be a lattice denoted by L less than or equal to. Okay, then the first property is commutative property. The first property is commutative property. So it states that for all AB belongs to lattice L, the first one is A meet B is equal to B meet A. Similarly, second one, A join B is equal to B join A. Okay, so here this is called join operation. This is join operation. Similarly, this is called as meet operation. Okay, so this one is join operation and this one is meet operation. Okay, so next property we have, that is second one, associative property. Associative property. So it states that for all ABC belongs to a lattice L, then A join B, A meet B meet C is equal to A meet of meet B meet C. And similarly, second one we have, this is also called as associative law. A join B join C is the same as A join B join C. So this is the second property known as associative property. Next, third one we have absorption property. Absorption property. So here in this we have A meet A join B is equal to A, and second one, A join A meet B is equal to A. So these are the important properties of a lattice. Okay, next comes the main principle, that is principle of duality. Principle of duality. So it states that the statement is every valid Boolean statement, every valid Boolean statement remains valid if if the join operation and meet operation are interchanged. Okay, so this is known as the principle of duality. For example, A join B is equal to B join A. This is one Boolean statement. So now this statement is valid here. A join B is equal to B join A. This is true. Now suppose if I interchange the join, this is a join operation. If I interchange join operation with the meet operation, I replace join operation by meet. A meet B is equal to B meet A. Then also this is a valid statement. So before replacing the meet operation with the join operation, the statement was valid, and even after replacing the join operation with the meet operation, then also it is a valid statement. So this is known as a principle of duality. So it states that every valid statement remains valid if join operation and meet operations are interchanged. Okay, so this is a principle of duality. Now we take distributive lattice. Okay, now A lattice L, comma less than or equal to is said to be a distributive lattice if for all A, B, C belongs to the lattice L, comma less than or equal to A meet B join C is equal to A meet C. And second one is A join B meet C is equal to A join B meet A join C. So this is the distributive lattice. Now we prove this statement. To prove this statement, what we do is we consider the second one. Okay, we consider the second one. So take the second one. What the second one says? A join B meet C is equal to A join B meet A join C. Okay. So now in this case, what we do is we take the RHS. So A join B meet A join C. Now we consider this and we prove this is equal to this one. Okay, so now consider this is equal to. So A join B meet A join C. Now what we do? We take this is equal to A join B, then A join B meet A. We group this element A join B meet A, next join A join B, then meet C. meet C. Okay, so that is, now what happened here? A join B meet A according to this by absorption property. So already we have studied the absorption property here. A meet, in this case A meet B, okay, A meet B join, A meet A join B is equal to A. Okay, now here A meet A join B. If you replace here, this can be written as A meet, first write this one A, then meet A join B, A join B, join A join B meet C. Okay, or this can be written as, that is by absorption property, this A meet A join B is equal to A. By using absorption property, A join A meet A join B is equal to A. So A meet A join B is equal to A. This is A. Next, A meet join A meet B meet C. Okay, here write, because A meet A join B is equal to A by absorption property. By absorption property. So which gives? So A join, okay, then A join B meet C. Now what we have to show? We have to show this is equal to A join B meet C. A join B meet C. Okay. So now what we do? We combine these two. Again, this can be written as A join A join of. Okay. Or this is nothing but what? Associative property. See here. This is one element. A join B join C. Right. So according to associative property, how we write this one? This can be written as A join B join C. It can be written as A join B join B meet C. So A join A is again A. This is join B meet C. You can write here, because A join A is equal to A. So now we have to show that this is equal to A join B meet C. A join B meet C. Thus, we have proved. Therefore, A join B meet A join C is equal to A join B meet C. Okay. Now, thus, we have proved this one. Now, to prove the second one. To prove the first one. Okay. To prove the first one. Here, this is the first one, first statement. To prove the first statement, next is to prove the first statement, we make use of principle of duality. Okay, we make use of principle of duality. So what principle of duality says? A valid statement remains valid if join and meet operations are interchanged. Okay, so now we write one statement by principle of duality. What happened then? Just interchange join and meet operation. Means wherever join is there, you replace it by meet, and wherever meet is there, you replace it by join. So now what I do? A, now join is there. Okay, this is a join. Now I replace this join by meet. So A meet B. Next, here meet is there, I replace it by join. Then A join is there, I replace by meet C is equal to. Now here A join is there, I replace it by meet. Next B, next here meet is there, I replace it by join. Now see, this is our First statement, A meet B join A meet C is equal to A meet B join C. So this is how we proved. Okay.